Welcome back to Chess Games and Analysis. Today I'm going to bring you an aggressive opening against e4 and d4, and we're starting right now. As I said in the intro, the opening can start with both d4 and e4. Let's begin by playing e4. After e4, we can play e6 or c5 to transpose to it. E6, the French defense, I would say this is the best way to transpose into the opening. Because if c5, a lot of people are going to play knight f3 and knight c3, some will play d4 and then we'll play e6. That's why I'm saying it's better to transpose to the French defense than play c5. This opening is called the Franco-Benoni, because the opening after d5 takes in d6 looks like a Benoni setup. It's called the Franco because of the French defense, just like the Franco-Sicilian, which we can transpose into. White now has three options: d5, d takes e5, and knight f3. As I said, knight f3 is just the Sicilian defense, and we'll get to that opening in a later video. After d5, we take the pawn, e takes, d6. Knight f6 is also an option. White can't push d6 because of queen b6. But today, we're mainly focusing on d6. White now has four options: knight f3, knight c3, c4, bishop b5. On knight f3, simply knight f6, knight c3, bishop to e7. We don't need to play g6, because we already have the e7 square for our bishop. Bishop e7, now white has two options: bishop e2, castles. As we can see here, black is doing fine. He'll normally develop his bishop to f5, knight d7, and queen b6. After bishop to b5 check, knight bd7, a4, castles, a6. The reason why our opponent played a4 is to strengthen his bishop, so we attack the bishop with a6, bishop e2, in b6, develop our bishop to b7, put our queen on c7, develop the rooks to the center, and black will be doing fine in this position. If knight c3, knight f6, knight f3 just transposes, bishop e2, bishop e7, h3 to prevent the bishop ever from coming to g4, castles, knight f3, knight a6. We play knight a6 to put our knight to c7 to help us advance the pawn to b5 and expand on the queen side, castles, knight c7. Black is doing fine here and should have an easy game developing his pieces. If h3, bishop e7, knight f3, castles, bishop e2, and we just transposed into the line that we just saw. If bishop e5, knight bd7, a4, bishop e7, knight f3, castles, a6, we've just transposed back to the line that we just saw. That's why I'm telling you this opening is very transpositional. If c4, g6, bishop d3, bishop g7, knight to c3, knight e7, because you don't want to block the bishop's long diagonal from h8 to a1, knight f3, bishop to g4 to pin the knight, h3, bishop takes, queen takes, knight d e7, castles, and queen d1. He plays queen d1 because we want to put our knight, this knight, all the way to e5 and attack both the queen and the bishop. And black was doing fine in that variation. If bishop to b5, check, knight to d7, knight f3, knight f6, castles, bishop e7, a4, castles, knight c3, a6, we transposed into another line of the Franco-Benoni. If your opponent plays d4, you have e6, or if c4, you can still play c5, and that we'll talk about that in the next video. He can also play e4, transposing into the Franco-Benoni. So, in this position, we'll mainly play c5, he can take, and we'll play e6. I am Eric Rosen, likes knight c3 in this position, and after takes, knight e4, bishop to b6, and knight check on d6, black can't castle, and white's king is safer. So if d5, e6, and we have just transposed back into the Franco-Benoni. Thank you all for watching. Please subscribe, like the video, dislike the video, share this video. Please help this video become popular so everybody can play my opening repertoire I've created. Thank you all for watching. See you in the next video.